A game about ancient warfare. There's not many games that tackle this seriously and in a turn-based fashion on the battlefield. And it looks similar to HBS, to the HBS series. A bit more straightforward, but we will see. First, let's check this here. What is this?
Starting in 490 BC, the all-conquering
old school
Persians
video.
Invaded Greece. At the battles of Marathon and Salamis, the invading forces were defeated. But Persia's influence lingered long after its armies retreated. Persian money, meddling, and diplomacy fomented trouble between the independent Greek city-states. Weakened and divided, Greece dreamed of revenge.
Sound check.
War of reprisal on the eternal Persian
Weakened and divided. Greece dreamed
Philip
of revenge.
II became the Macedonian king in 359 BC. A strong ruler, he created a well-trained army and expanded his kingdom in all directions. In 338 BC, he defeated the Greek Confederation at Chaeronea and proclaimed himself general-in-chief of the Greeks for the long-sought-after war of revenge against Persia. Assassinated in 336 BC, Philip was succeeded by his 20-year-old son, now Alexander III of Macedonia, soon to be known as Alexander the Great. Acclaimed king, Alexander moved quickly to secure his power, brutally crushing revolts, securing his rear lines, and destroying Thebes, a leading Greek city. Then leaving half his army to protect the secured Macedonian homeland, Alexander led the rest and his Greek Confederation troops onward into Asia Minor to continue the war against Persia declared by his father. Ancient authors asserted that Alexander was like a force of nature. He certainly entered Asia in a spectacular manner, emulating the fabled Greek heroes, joyfully splashing ashore at the site of mythical Troy and claiming the armor of legendary Achilles. By May 334 BC, the local Persian governors assembled a formidable army at the Granicus River, but Alexander swept them aside and pushed into Asia, always taking care to secure the seacoast and major ports along his march. The powerful Persian navy could threaten Macedonian communications until Alexander captured their bases. By late 333 BC, Persian Emperor Darius III amassed a powerful army, then moved on the swiftly advancing Macedonians, who were marching south from Asia Minor. Alexander attacked the Persians at Issus, where, as usual, he personally led his cavalry in
repeated...
Alexander closed within a few yards of Darius, who fled in his golden chariot, along with his dispirited Persian host. Following Issus, Alexander continued along the coast, marching to the Phoenician seaport of Tyre, a major Persian navy base. An island fortress, Tyre was a formidable challenge.
It's basically a short summary documentary
the city was finally stormed in August
of
332 BC by picked Macedonian troops who used a laboriously constructed mold
Alexander's
as
campaign
for their final brutish assault. Alexander entered Egypt in late 332 BC, completing his conquest of the Persian sea bases and finishing off the famed Persian navy. Alexander paused long enough to be declared a god by Egyptian priests and to found the great city of Alexandria. Alexander marched northeast to meet the Persians in Mesopotamia. In October 331 BC, the Macedonians found the huge Persian army awaiting them on the leveled and prepared plain of Gaugamela. Although heavily outnumbered and having his left flank turned, Alexander, as at Issus, once again personally charged directly at Darius. Darius again fled, leaving his vast army to disintegrate without him. During his desperate flight into the desert, the reign of Darius III ended in assassination by treacherous courtiers. His empire fell into the hands of Alexander, who occupied the heart of the old Persian Empire.
In 330 BC, during a drunken celebration, Alexander destroyed Persepolis, the Persian capital, as revenge for the burning of Athens 150 years before.
Background, some fanfare music, while it's about burning and killing civilians.
For the next 3 years, Alexander moved east, conducting a bewildering series of marches and countermarches, stamping out the last vestiges of the old rule and pacifying nomadic
tribes. I like the music. It is something between Rachel, reminding me of some, I don't know. Alexander then those old school RPGs, Super Nintendo RPGs, something like, what is it called? Chrono Trigger.
Marched beyond Greek maps into
but I like it, really good soundtrack.
May 326 BC, he defeated the Indians in a brutal battle at the Hydaspes River. In July of the same year, Alexander's homesick army mutinied. Alexander gave in to his veterans' demands, and the great conquering army, after much hardship, returned to Mesopotamia.
Jesus Christ, man. Can you imagine that those guys, most of them were on foot? You know?
On his return,
in the modern military, you're happy if you have good boots and proper fitting boots. I wonder if they, but I guess so, that they had back in the days those sandals they used. If they were really comfy for long marches, but I guess out of desperation their body will take everything. 33 years, yes. Hiked through the complete known world. Yeah, it was a great video. I like it that they made it like this. However, I would have made it a bit different. I already checked it. You have all those historical battles. Which is okay. One thing, especially for those that are not experts on Alexander's campaign, it would be of course great to provide a path of those battles. And there's also a campaign, but it seems this campaign is some sort of a random generated thing. You have battles, there's immediate battle, but there's not much information provided. It reminds me a bit, it's some bare bone campaign system like in Field of Glory 2. Some might like it, I'm not the biggest fan of it, however I didn't check it out, but immediately nothing, there's immediately a battle going on. I guess somewhere in Macedonia. But we will play the historical battles, I'm way more interested in those. And I would rather made, or at least provided the option for having also a linear campaign of those battles, and then splitting this video, this historical video, as introductions of those battles. That would be great. And sure, you can have this full video, perhaps unlock it when you play it through, whatever, you know, stuff like this. Okay. Yes, let's start a battle. We will fight in... First battle where Alexander fought alongside his father against the Greek city-states. One of my best total war experiences, however, I was really young, so if you're young, a lot of stuff is greater than it might be, was the Alexander DLC for Rome Total War. It's not that widely known, because it was released, there was, I think, Barbarian Invasion or something called, that was a big expansion pack, not DLC. Back in the days, there was not this words like DLC, there was expansions. And then there was this relator for Rome, many didn't even mention it, this Alexander released, And I played through it, and it was really great difficulty. I almost didn't manage it, but it was really great. Felt like replaying Alexander's campaign. Is considered not to be that good, because I guess it doesn't offer that much content, but it became for me a really great experience, one of the best Total War experiences, together with Medieval 2 and mods like Stainless Steel. Okay. This is, yeah, we'll leave it on standard. Yeah, that's the graphics. They're quite functional. It reminds a bit of games like HPS, Ancient Warfare. You have three zoom levels. I'm running on Windows 10. You can get this on GOG in a Total Collection. We will check also the two other games. I won't play the complete battle. I just want to get give an overview and also get an overview for myself. It's the first time I'm properly playing it. It looks definitely more straightforward than, at least from a beginner's perspective, than something like HPS. Okay, that's Javelins. That is Kev. That are our Pilotas. I think it's not a bad idea. Is there a turn limitation? I don't think so. Yeah, you can get your troops simply by clicking into move. Good thing is you can, looks like, get multiple units into move at the same time, which I really like. Looks quite straightforward. I'm only commanding the left flank because Philip is commanding the right. Okay. Yeah, I'm in charge of the artillery of the cav. Range 1. Okay. Yeah, currently I see no opening for. Let's see how Philip, what Philip will decide. Undo last unit action, cascade the windows. Okay, that was. But. Great, I mean, why not? What's this? I don't think that's needed. Come for screen back. Reverse view. Ah, okay, Hex grid. Overview map. Yeah, not really that useful, I think. Perhaps if you have smaller resolution, it might be helpful. Yeah, let's remove it. Okay, information. Missile volley. About face. Finnish leader. Okay, I think I'm fine. I want to see how the Macedonian center and right flank reacts. And check the other interface stuff. Save. Leader, yeah, some other stuff you already have in those menus. It is really similar to HPS or to some John Tiller games. Vertical. Okay, this window splitting. But what is it good for? Can I? Finnish leader. Showing exchange. Yeah, that was not my plan. My plan was, of course, to throw javelins and keep them in the skirmish. Not in, perhaps they're doing it right now. great to have a bit higher speed. It's a bit slow. I'm not sure if I... But there might be a hotkey or something. Perhaps it is indeed the John Teller hotkey, right? F6, F7. That would be funny. Okay, it looks like you are basically responsible for different leaders. Now we have Philip's army ready. God damn it, that's not what I wanted. I think engaging... This is a paired unit. Those guys were assigned to Alexander, whatever. Something, I think there's a limitation on how many units you can move in a command phase, it seems, which is a good idea. I mean, it's indeed a good idea, because I can't do anything anymore, so I guess there must be a system in place here. Philip, command range 9, initiative 6. We moved 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units. So it could be that the initiative tells you how many units you can move in a single turn, which I like. It's quite a refreshing system. I always like if you need there's some not enough games that put stress on this, that you can't command everywhere everything. In most games you do it, in reality you can't do it that easily. You can't, I don't know, sure you can pre-plan everything, but you usually they back in the days they forked in a orderly fashion, not because it was tactically that effective, but also because they didn't have other means to organize an attack or organize whatever. Archers forward, you know, right cavalry charge, and then they charge. There was not charge, then go behind the enemy, then do this and that, you know, this. They had to maintain it, to keep it simple. Yeah, I think that's it, right? Finnish leader. What I like is the controls of this game. They are quite. That's when I tested out HPS. It was sometimes, but could be that if you have practice, it's easier. But what I like is that you're straight. You can play this game with two mouse clicks. I think that was not that easy in HPS. Only one thing annoying me is the speed. But I think that there should be some way to speed it up, right? Because this game is indeed very slow. I don't like when games are so slow. It really starts to get on my nerves. I don't like slow things. So hotkey list. Yeah, here in the manual you can also the battles are. The battles are also in the manual. The battles are sorted. Of course, you can look up Alexander's battle or whatever it is in order to have to play it like a campaign. But I think those videos would be way better cut into introductions of the battles, would give those battles a lot of immersion. Yeah, and looks like there's some, this is not some simple, some game where you simply move around. There's stuff like Zone of Control. Uh, is even the maker of it? Interactive Magic, okay. Yeah, whatever, I don't know how to... if there is a way to speed it up. Good, next. Who's next? Philip again? Okay, interesting. I said a different leader here. Now, Philip is here and... whatever, let's continue. Oh, these guys. Oh, this is light infantry. So TQ8, it's USI6. Great to get quick information what this is. It's getting the higher ground here. One dude disappeared. What happened? He sank into the water. Yeah, this is not really proper terrain here. I don't know if, but one tile, there is a unit, undo last action, retail, whatever. You do not have enough orders to move that unit, does not belong to your group. Yeah, okay. Okay, that's it. Skirmishers were a joke. That's not how I wanted. Not skirmishers, I mean, they're carrying javelins, but Trace, Thassa, and Thassa. They look to me like skirmishing units. Yeah, they look for me like skirmishers. I mean, what else they are supposed to do? They should throw the javelins and GTO. But it looks like they got into the fight here, and okay, next, Alexander's calf. Who's responsible? Is it the command range? Yeah, it could be that it is the command range. It is belonging to Philip's unit, but he's out of command range, so we can't command him. I like it. So you need, this is a leader-based, a leader-focused game, which is basically what Ancient Warfare was about. Complete armies routed when the leaders were neutralized. Okay, the center is opening up. Could, wasn't even something like this that I charged right into some opening, kill some leaders, wreck havoc. Others we could get. You know, this calf is really fast. So there's some targets of opportunity here. Or we will wait. And no wait. Oh. Who is this guy? Why there? Oh man, those routing units are blocking my calf. Are you kidding me? Stupid SOBs run right in front of my calf, and looks like the calf is blocked by them. Like, this is really some bad luck here. But yeah, this is interesting. You need to watch out also where your units route, otherwise you might end up like this. Because turning is really difficult for them. Yeah, this basically threw off my calf charge here. Those stupid idiots here ran right in front of the calf. Because, yeah. HE, heavy infantry, okay. Heavy infantry. Like what? Phalanx. Heavy infantry. Liked. Yeah, but still, like phalanx is something like phalanx heavy. Yeah, there's some letters provided which I think tell heavy calf. Yeah, okay. Commander. Mm-hmm. Phalanx heavy. Something like this. Yeah, but this guy's, I don't know, that didn't work out. Is there a skirmish mode? Because that doesn't make sense that they got themselves into contact with heavy infantry. They should have thrown a jazz and simply retreated. Yeah, this is just a showcase here. This is already a bit, but yeah, we learn the game as we play. This is of course not optimal. This calf charge here, we might would have waited until those remnants would have get away. I just want to see how this game works, but it looks like you need to consider what you're doing, as in reality a single bad maneuvering can put you into a really bad shape, as in other games as well. It is similar to, I guess, to a Field of Glory 2. What I like is this initiative of the leaders. I think that's in Field of Glory. I don't know. There is leaders in Field of Glory, but I don't know. Yeah, perhaps it's also there. You can play it like this. Who is it now? The animation could be definitely faster. Who is this guy? Let's greet him. I mean, at least two calf units can get. He doesn't want to be with us. Okay. Not sure if I want to get that close. We could end up in the zone of control, but let's check it out. Could be that the calf gets. Even if it is not on face. Okay. Not sure why those units were allowed to move another time, the others not. Not. Yeah, I guess I have not enough initiative anymore. Yeah, throw your jazz and get out of there. Yeah. No! This is heavy infantry. Yeah. Daddy! They punched me. Yeah, no wonder, my friend. You are fighting heavy infantry with your tunicas there. There's not a lot of movement in the Greek. What is this? This guy is absolutely here. Okay, whatever. Now it's Philip's time again. Yeah, let's see. Is there some? Because we need to get close and missile volley. Did something happen? No. Perhaps I need to press him. Hello? Yeah, I don't know exactly it is. Why those? Because of the terrain. Yeah, they can attack those guys. Oh wait, this button here. Yeah, missile volley. Yeah, but it's, I guess, something for true archer units, true missile units. I mean, a javelin is liked. Yeah, but it's not a missile unit, it's simply liked phalanx or liked infantry, whatever. With javelins, but however, as the guy look like, I guess they are not designed for skirmishing. Okay, here, Philip, get behind your your main formation. Those guys can join in. Ah, damn it, that costs initiative. Should have waited. Yeah, initiative spent. Again, I guess it is simply because our commanders have a high skill, initiative. Initiative could also mean that it is also normally initiative, I would rather mean how often they can command. Perhaps it is both. How many units? Because I think it is always, let's see, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whatever, but yeah, there's definitely a limit of how many units you can move at the same time. And commanders have, I guess those guys are really have low initiative or low initiative, free. Because the Greek commanders back then, Philip was a really seasoned and also a genius commander. And yeah, Alexander followed him. And yeah, they both simply have better ability, which is fine. So, will we bypass or will we attack those? I guess we will attack them. Or let's leave them for the heavy infantry. But it's Cav. I mean, charging with the phalanx into the Cav is pretty good. Leaving the flank open for Cav, I wouldn't like it. That's and the rest continue. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, 6 units moved, and that's it. Even gain some cohesion hit because they moved through a minor river. A single horse running around. Yeah, this horse is definitely gone. Again, Philip. To watch out, bring up, but I want to get into contact and then we will bring in the second line. I also want to have enough room for maneuvering. Interesting, they're crossing the river first, okay, if you say so, my friend, but perhaps they saw a chance here. But I think they crossed the river, which I plan to do. Yeah, the calf is doing a good job in keeping distance. Okay, Alexander's turn. What is this unit? Are they out of... Nah, they can't be out of command range. Command range is 5. Are they not belonging to me? Are they belonging to Philip? Looks like Macedonia, and those are the Agema companions. Whatever, I will, then I will leave them back. They also are like cavalry and companions. Nobody else, those companions should belong to me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Command range should be fine. Whatever, but something is wrong with them. Or they're belonging to the other army, so we will go forward. Because I need to handle the charge here. Is it not allowed to attack commanders? But I mean, this should hamper command, right? If we are... That's interesting. So this is not a kill the general game. No, wait, they can't attack anything currently. Is this something I need to do? Is this... Does Kaff need to speed up? Whatever, get in the back, perhaps it needs... Kev has some special rules, I guess. This guy's just stopped in a track. Okay. Because this... Do I need to trigger it? The manual should tell you, but I guess Kev needs some special preparation in order to make a charge. Good, but those guys are really pressed now. We're behind enemy lines, and perhaps next turn we can utilize this. What? The animations are funny. Why the heck are they retreating? They are also retreating. Okay. What? Hey! Ah, come on, this... Yeah, this, I don't know what I've expected from the Macedonian phalanx. Percy should attack rather than stay defensive. I mean, that shouldn't play that much, shouldn't make that much difference for those guys. What the heck are they doing? Okay, I guess the ground conditions weren't the best. Is this the enemy in front of us? Yeah, I don't know where this game stands compared to Field of Glory 2. What I'm still lacking is simply a game with an engaging campaign system. It's a really good campaign system that is definitely not Field of Glory 2. It's quite a bare-bone campaign system, which basically generates you some random battles. Sure, there are battles you can download, but yeah, it's somehow... So it doesn't, no fun, it plays everything so random, without presentation, anything. Just troop DLCs all over the place. For multiplayer, I guess it is quite a blast if you don't care about presentation and single player. From a single player perspective, I find I'm looking for something that gives you, I don't know, the combat mission experience, the combat mission campaign experience, you know, with background, stuff like this, translated onto an ancient battlefield. There was recently a game I played called Century 13 or Medieval Century. It is a game that is, I don't know, extremely bad reviews. I got it for 50 cents. I made a video about all three games and I was surprised. It is not the game of the games, but it is quite a solid game, and most of the stuff reported, it doesn't work, don't buy it, and I played it, it immediately worked, no crashes, nothing. And this game had, for example, a good presentation there. You had really those battles, historical battles. You could select a nation, and then those battles were presented with videos. Sure, the game itself is somewhat Total War, it is more arcadey on the warfare. I think there's still no real game, except for some, perhaps some Total War mods, medieval mods. There's nothing that ever tried to authentically recreate true medieval or ancient or true melee warfare. I mean, on simulation level, you know. Those turn-based things here, they come close, something like, yeah, but Field of Glory also has some, but because it comes from this board game, I think, and, or HPS, but real time, I think there's nothing really trying to hit the realism. No, not that I could think of, because I'm really itching for ancient or medieval warfare with good presentation. Something I know, perhaps in the vein of Scourge of War, where it really is hard, like in this game, you need to make choices what to command, where to command. Is this frustrating? Do you mean, is this a statement, or is this a question? Sounds like a question to me. Okay, who is... it's Alex's turns. Yeah, still, I don't know exactly how to. I guess it has also something to do with facing. But how to utilize. Ah, look at this. I could charge into those guys, which I don't want to do. But I can't charge into the commander. Is this costing points, by the way? No, I don't think so. Which is good. Can I turn like I want? No. Okay. It's over. Okay, yeah. Damn it. Because sometimes, yeah. too much disco. Yeah, we have some routing units here. Which we can charge. Don't see that much use in it. Let's charge into those guys. That sounds like a plan. Oof. But if in a serious game playthrough, I would come from behind and then really smash into them and give them the rest. Sure, there's a big part of this army, but it's isolated. One thing, I guess those leaders are basically have a diplomat status. It seems they can operate on the map without getting into harm's way, it seems. So there's a gentleman's agreement, which was of course not the case back in the days. Question. If it was a statement, it'd be, this is frustrating. Yeah, if it would be a question, there would be a proper sentence structure as a question mark. No, it is not frustrating. I think it's quite straightforward to control. There are other games that often have some work cycles that make it more annoying. To command, to get stuff done. Yeah, sure, this facing. Is there some hotkey for it? No. That is the only thing you need access to the interface for. And there's no fast way, at least not with a mouse or some quick commands. But other than that, it's quite straightforward. You can move multiple units. And at the same time, it could be faster. I don't know if there's an option to set speed. It could be faster. So, next. Yeah, I think I got an idea about this. I will now check out the other two games that come with this collection after a short break. There's, what was it, Caesar and... What was the third one? Hannibal? I don't know. We will see it. I won't get too deep into those games if they are similar. I just want to see if they offer some different features. I don't know that much about the series, if it is basically the same engine with three different battle sets. Or if there are differences. So I will come back in 5 minutes, get something to drink, a coffee or whatever, and then